Hello and welcome to 5-Minute Math. Today we're looking at the 6th grade concept of integers, specifically how we can add, subtract, multiply, and divide integers, and we will do it in 5 minutes or less. So let's take an expression that we might see in a 6th grade math textbook, negative 5 minus 3. Well, if I'm going to start, let's say our negative 5 is right here. We know that our subtraction here moves us to the left. But really, let me go ahead and rewrite this as negative 5 minus positive 3. We can look at that 3 as a positive because our negative or subtraction is our operation. Now, typically we wouldn't look at it like this, but what we see here is we see a negative and a positive. And sometimes you'll see a negative and a positive, or a positive and a negative. Anytime you get two signs that are next to each other, but they're opposite, meaning one's a positive, one's a negative, it's going to end up as a negative. And that's why you can write this as negative 5 minus positive 3, but really we just simplify it. We just say negative 5 minus 3. You start at negative 5, you subtract 3, and you're going to get over here to negative 8. And that's fairly simple. But what happens if I change this expression right here? What if I change it to negative 5 minus, but rather than a positive 3, I'm going to make it a negative 3. Negative 5 minus negative 3. Well, now you see I have two negatives right next to each other. So I have two signs that are the exact same. They're next to each other. Well, if negative 5 minus positive 3 makes me go to the left, negative 5 minus negative 3 is actually going to go in the opposite direction. It's actually going to move to the right, and that's going to get me to negative 2. And so whenever you have two signs that are next to each other that are the same, whether it be negative, negative, or whether it be a positive and positive, those always end up as a positive. And the same thing works for multiplication and division. Let's start with a simple multiplication problem that we all know. 4 times 2. Well, really what you're looking at is 4 groups of 2. So I'm going to draw 4 groups here. And I'm going to say, I've got 2, I've got 2, I've got 2, and I've got 2. Well, that's going to make 8. And really, that 4 times 2, both of those are positive. Because if you don't see a sign, you can always assume it's a positive. So it's a positive 4 times positive 2, and that's going to get you a positive 8. We just don't write the positives. Because remember, two signs that are the same always makes a positive. But what happens if I change this to where it is 4 groups of negative 2? Well, 4 groups of negative 2, or 4 times negative 2, is going to be a negative 2, a negative 2, a negative 2, and a negative 2. 4 groups of negative 2, well, that's going to make negative 8. Because when you have a positive and a negative, that always makes a negative. And then finally, what happens if I have negative 4 times negative 2? Well, look at our key over here. 2 negatives always makes a positive. So really, negative 4 groups of negative 2 is going to make positive 8. Same way, if we divide 8 divided by 4, well, that's going to make 2. But if we have 8 divided by, and we'll have to put parentheses here, negative 4, well, you've got 8 divided by, and then you've got a negative 4, so that's a positive and a negative. Well, that's going to make negative 2. So when you're adding, subtracting, multiplying, or dividing integers, the key is to look at the signs. If the two signs are opposite, it's going to be a negative. If the two signs are the same, but whether both positive or both negative, it's going to end up as a positive. Now it's time for you to try. Take a moment and solve these 4 expressions. Make sure you use order of operations on this final one. And when you have your answers, unpause the video and check your work. This first one, 8 times 3 is 24. We have a negative 8, positive 3. That makes negative 24. Here we've got 2 negatives, so that makes it a positive. Negative 4 plus 6 actually makes positive 2. We have a negative and negative, so it's going to cancel each other out to make a positive 7. And then these two negatives multiplied by each other make a positive, so 4 plus 12 is 16.